Hey friends, welcome back. It's Danielle. I have my October 2019 budget with me on my Erin Condren Deluxe Monthly Planner for you here. So I hope this is very helpful for you. I know a lot of you guys love pen and paper budgeting, and this is exactly how we do it. So Tyler and I are a dual income, no kid couple living in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. We're paid bi-weekly, but we do a monthly budget on a monthly spread. So this is the Erin Condren Deluxe Monthly Planner. You can do this in a life planner. You can do it in any sort of calendar, printacalendar.com, however you want to do it. Pull up a calendar and start writing it out. So I'm going to share with you step by step exactly how we're doing our real life budget. So let's get started with paydays. So Tyler's first payday and my first payday are going to be on the 9th and 11th. So I'm in my sunroom. I hope this doesn't echo too much, but there's great lighting out here without me having to pull out any extra lights. Tyler got a bit of a raise, so that was awesome to be able to see that. Okay, he also gets per diem. We already know what this one's going to be because today is the 4th. Erasable pens to the rescue. I don't do a voiceover for this. So you get to see budgeting in all its glory. So I have, before I started the video, I did go ahead and plan out everything, and I was off by $4. I could not, for the life of me, figure out why I was off $4. And I know that I was off $4 because I budget, as you guys saw in a previous video, on everydollar.com, as well as doing this. So I always set this budget up first. And then I go and I plug in all of the numbers on everydollar.com. And the reason I do it twice is because I want to be able to keep up with my transactions for line items that are used multiple times throughout the month on everydollar, because it's very, very easy to do that. Okay, so since we are not paid until the 9th, we have to bring in some income so that we can pay for food and gas and other things that happen before the 9th, because $156.50 doesn't cover a whole lot. So we roll money over from the previous month's income into this month. That was exactly $431.76. So this is my commission and hourly check. So that will be $16.97. Tyler's paydays are expected to be $13.35.25. And then this one is just for my hourly. So that will be on the 23rd. And that's always approximate. So our budget does change lots throughout the month. But that's not an excuse not to make a budget. Or make a budget right now. So even if it's not your payday and you want to make a budget for your next payday, start with the money that you have now, call it rollover, and then add in income and expenses as you go. So we get one more source of income, and that's YouTube. So thank you guys so much for watching my video and commenting. The more you comment, the more this is shown to new people, and I know I'm getting new people every day. The budgeting community is growing and I love it. Debt-free community on Instagram is also growing. So if you guys have any channels that are awesome and I should follow them, let me know in the comments below, because I'm always looking for new subscriptions. The more I immerse myself in the debt-free community on YouTube and Instagram, the more money I save, because it's always getting me thinking about saving money and making more money and stuff like that. So I always want to subscribe to new people who are looking to either get out of debt or looking to not use their credit card. Okay, so that is all of our sources of income for the month of October. If we do get anything extra, we will fill it in then. Next up, bills that have due dates. So let's start with Ready Refresh. So this was only $31.05. That's our water delivery service, because we have a well. We don't want to drink the water, because we did have it tested before we moved in, and it doesn't have, it's not like the best thing ever. Verizon, this bill also went down from the every dollar budget. It's due on the 10th and it's $275.85. So the only reason I can think of it went down, because we got the monthly credit for the buy one, get one free on the Note 10 Pluses. We have YouTube Premium. We're going to abbreviate that YTP. So if you guys hear anything extra in the background, it's probably a stupid stink bug. Do you guys have stink bugs where you're at? Leave me a comment with that one because I'm very curious, because we will uproot our entire lives to move to a place that doesn't have stink bugs. Dollar Shave Club. I have a referral link down in the description box below for that. $10.68. This will be the first time Tyler and I are getting razors in like 3 months. We skipped the past 2 months. We get a single pack of four blades, or cartridges, I guess I should say, and that lasts us like forever. Spectrum's our internet. It's $50.99. That bill went down because we did buy our own routers. We still use their modem, but it went down $5 because we bought our own router. So, oh, that is something that I wanted to talk with you guys about. We did put our phones on the payment plan with Verizon because we got the buy one, get one free. And the earliest we can pay those off is 6 months. Although we don't typically pay those off anyway. Now I know Dave Ramsey and a lot of other people consider those phones to be debt, but I don't. Phone bills with contracts used to be higher when you got a free phone. Well, now that phones aren't free, you have to pay for the phone. The service itself is lower. So it's pretty much equaling out for the phone companies and for your bill. So I do not consider those debt. I would be paying a phone bill anyway. So it's just a different amount than I would have paid before. So we have Duke is our electricity, $165.20. Life insurance for Tyler, $74.48. Netflix was $17.07. YouTube TV, we're going to abbreviate that, $53.36. Tyler's been watching football on that, and I have been watching HDTV, and we love it. YouTube Premium is also definitely worth it. No ads. My Roth IRA maintenance fee is $20 per quarter, so that will be due at the beginning of next month. But again, we will not be getting paid on the first, so I'm going to go ahead and pay it this month. Mortgage is also due on the first. It's $13.89.17. Okay, I think those are all of the bills that have due dates. Anything that might auto draft automatically. I do have one thing that will auto draft that I don't really consider a bill, but it is a monthly expense, is Young Living. Let's see, it's going to be $61.38 this month, and we're going to be getting Tyler's shave cream. Oh my gosh, and two other things. Oh, a lavender oatmeal body soap in a bar form. And oh my gosh, one more thing. I don't remember what it is. Oh well. Okay, so next up, items that are essential but are variable. So for us, that's food, gas, restaurants, personal money. And now, first time ever, we are going to be splitting up our food budget. So normally food for us is anything you can buy at Walmart, pretty much. Cleaning supplies, household supplies that are consumable, and then also typically beauty products. So face wash, stuff like that, anything we don't get from Young Living. I put Young Living in its own category because it does auto draft. I set that up to auto draft on like the 8th. I go ahead and put it on the 6th just to be sure to remind myself to go ahead and make sure the money is in the account and to make sure I don't want to switch out my products. So that's why I do count that as a separate line item from our beauty budget, because it does have cleaning supplies in there as well. Okay, so let's put these in. So I'm going to change things up. We're going to put our four main categories on my payday. So we're going to have food, gas, restaurants, and personal. Now, this is a really interesting budget for me. It's definitely different, but I'm going to be going ahead and putting those same categories up here on the first. So by putting them on this payday with that paycheck, I want to budget money for those categories. But with this rollover, I also want to budget money for those categories. Okay, and then also for this paycheck, now our restaurant budget from here on the first and here on the ninth will cover us for the rest of the month. I'm going to go ahead and make these a little bit larger than they necessarily maybe need to be, but then we're just going to have that money in our checking account to cover us for the rest of the month. So food, gas, restaurants, personal. So household and beauty. We will not need anything for the household. So I'm considering household items consumable. So that's going to be trash bags, light bulbs, cleaning supplies, bug spray, stuff like that. Toilet paper, paper towels. So I'm going to budget household here on the 14th. Anything for the house like decorations, a shovel, weed eater, I don't know. Anything like that that's not a consumable product. Like, you only have to buy a shovel once, pretty much. You might need to buy a different kind of shovel, but you're going to keep that first shovel. So that kind of stuff I'm going to put under a category called house. And so that's just going to be like one-time sort of purchases, not stuff that's consumable month by month. Household and beauty. So for these kind of things, they don't really have due dates. I just kind of throw them on a day that's after the payday I'm going to use to pay them. And that's kind of empty. So I have several items already on this box. I don't want to fill it up even further. So I'm going to just, you know, pick a day in here and throw it on that day. Okay, so the budgets for these food for the whole month is going to be $300. Oh my gosh. You guys know we can spend some money on food. Gas is going to be $180. I got my rental car because if you follow me on Instagram, you know that my car got hit by a deer. It ran into the side of my car. I did not hit the deer. The deer hit me. So I cannot open my driver's side door, so I took it to the shop. Luckily, our insurance is covering everything. I have no deductible for the rental. I have no deductible for them fixing my car, nothing like that. The only thing I'm going to be paying for the rental is the insurance. So if there's another collision and there's a total loss on the rental, I want to be covered. We overinsure everything. So you'll see that in the budget here in just a minute. Restaurants, $200. Okay, so this one's really, really super high. And then really, really super high because we've already spent over $100 and today is the 4th. I'm not kidding. Yeah, it's bad. We like to go out to eat. We love to eat at home and I wish we had more days off. I get to, Tyler gets to, I get home at 8:30, 8:45 sometimes, and then like we try to be in bed by 10:30. I don't know, sometimes a meal takes 40 minutes to cook and what, 20 minutes to prep? I don't know. We've got to figure something out. Okay, personal money for the month. So, restaurants, for the month we have $400. For personal money, I've got one more little line item. We're going to sporadically give ourselves this money. So these are going to be really super uneven numbers. And the reason for that is we almost do a paycheck to paycheck budget. So if you guys follow a lot of people on YouTube, Plan Hill and Be Merry, I love her. There are lots of other YouTubers that do this, but they budget by the paycheck. And so I've always kind of done that. We've always done a monthly budget and then we break it down into paycheck to paycheck budgets. And so that's why this number, I have chosen this category to be the uneven number, so that once we budget per paycheck, everything gets, every one of those paychecks is zero before we move on to the next paycheck. So those are our main categories. Next up, our dog Bentley gets a budget for the month. He needs food already, but everything else of his can wait in the month. And we want to get him a new collar. He's growing. He's like 8 months old now. So he gets $200 for the month. Lawn care is our next line item that gets used multiple times throughout the month. Since we are moving into cooler months, which seems like a lie, if you are like anywhere in the eastern half of the US, if I'm not sorely mistaken, there's like this insane heat wave. So Memphis, Tennessee, where Penny's Not Perfection is, up in New Jersey, I saw someone on Instagram. It's like insanely hot. It's 92 degrees today or something like that. And it's October. So I foresee having to mow the lawn at least twice. We may also use our lawn guy for removing leaves. Not really sure how that's going to work yet. Okay. Haircut is another line item, and medical is another line item that we always keep in the budget, but we don't always assign money to it. So medical is pretty much going to be like our CBD for the month. We may or may not continue with that. I don't know. I think that's it. It's looking pretty full, isn't it? Okay, so next up are one-time line items. That is going to be savings. Let's put savings on Saturday. Savings for the month is going to be $199.22. It's an odd number because I always like to round our account up to the $0. Like, I do not like to have change in my savings account. So that will shore us up to a nice round dollar in that account. So when I look at the account, it's very easy to see if anything's been moved or used or anything like that. And then the car thing. So I'm not sure when the car is going to be fixed, but we're going to budget for it. Here, $222.58. Oh, I did not assign personal money here. Okay, $75.83, $27.95, and personal money of $55.60. That will give us, $140.62. That will give us $300 in personal money for the month. So I did assign some money up here because I did a giveaway and we had a winner that was eligible to win, and I sent that out today. So you should be getting your Levoit humidifier on Monday. I'm super excited. I love doing giveaways, and I love when companies support the debt-free community by giving me free stuff. Okay, and then the very last two line items. We have rollover that we count as income, so we have rollover that we count as an expense, and I always put that on the very last box. Going to be $645.12, and that leaves us with money for the house. We need a tree taken down that we were told was going to cost $900. So if we don't actually use that money, it will go into a sinking fund. If we get paid a little bit more on one of our paychecks or per diem or something like that, we will put it all toward the house. So when you're making your budget, you want to have maybe one or two line items that could change throughout the month. Set yourself a budget for food. Set yourself a personal money budget. But have that one line item, whether it's debt, whether it's savings, whether it is goals for the house, have the one line item. If you get extra income, you know it's going to go toward that. But if nothing changes, that will be the number that we get to put toward our house. So next up, highlighters. Now, this is where the paycheck to paycheck budget comes in. So we've done a monthly budget. All the numbers add up. If you add up all of the incomes and subtract all of the expenses, you will see $0. But you can't just go paying for your mortgage when you have $431.76 sitting in your checking account. Now, can you? So you have to budget per paycheck. And the way to do that is to highlight and add. So before the video started, I added up this rollover money, $431.76, the per diem of $156.50. And I started subtracting off food for $100, gas for $60, restaurants for $200, and personal for $75.83. Ready Refresh for $31.05, Bentley's expense for $60, and Young Living for $61.38. So these two incomes minus all of those expenses will equal zero. Next up, let's use yellow. My payday of $16.97 and Tyler's payday of $13.35.25 is going to cover food, gas, restaurants, personal, Verizon, more for Bentley, YouTube Premium, lawn, savings, household, beauty, Spectrum. Now, I want to pause here. We're not quite done, but I do want to pause. Dollar Shave Club is auto drafted. You can't pay that early. So, although it's a very tiny expense, I'm not budgeting for it out of these paychecks. I'm going to budget for it out of this per diem. So, I hope that makes sense. Let me know if you have any questions about that kind of thing. But I always try to pay bills as early as possible if I can. And for anything that's auto drafted, I don't want my checking account just sitting there with money in it because then it looks like we have more than we actually do. Okay, so those paychecks are going to go to pay for the electricity bill, the mortgage, and the Roth IRA maintenance fee. Normally, I will include the per diem as part of the paycheck, but I really want to get really super specific. If you guys saw the September budget review, you know that we spent money basically like crazy. We spent a ton of money and we did not need to. You know, we have things that we really, really want. And then we have things that we immediately want. And we want to have money in our savings. I want a new car. I want to have this tree taken down that's next to our house. Those are things I really, really do want. I don't just need them, I want them, right? And so sometimes we talk about needs versus wants, but you don't really hear needs versus real wants versus wants. True wants versus immediate wants. And so for us, we were focusing on our immediate wants, not our true wants. And so in order to really focus on what we really, really want, we have to get really, really specific with this budget. Am I spending $300 on beauty products throughout the month? No, but I'm probably getting like at least, depending on the month, $150 because my moisturizer is 62 and or something like that, like 70, and then my face wash is like 40. So Do I need those every month? How often are we buying them? So that's another thing. Because we buy that in person, we don't buy it on Amazon. It's really easy to track your purchases on Amazon, especially since we don't do a whole lot of purchasing on Amazon. So for us, we know we buy toilet paper and we buy the biggest pack possible, and it's like $35. But we only have to buy it every 3 months. So our household budget for $20 this month, sometimes we also have to buy paper towels, and we only do that once every 3 or 4 months. And so that month, our household budget will need to be $100. This month, we don't need any of that stuff, so I went ahead and budgeted $20 just in case we need something. So just in case. But again, if we come in under budget on any particular category, it will probably go toward the house fund. If we come in over budget, restaurants and food, we might, then we will reevaluate from there. What that means for us is that we will not hit our true goal of our true want of getting this tree taken down and getting $900 in that house fund. So that is the budget. That is every single one of our line items for the month of October 2019. So we don't have anything planned for Halloween as of yet, but we have personal money in the budget, and that will cover it. We do not count, pretty much the only thing we count outside of personal would be birthdays and birthdays and Christmas. Any other holiday, we're probably going to include it in personal money or gift money. So Valentine's Day, we might include in gift money. We typically just go out to eat. At that point, we still include that in our restaurant budget. We don't put that as a separate line item. So we don't borrow, because we don't use cash, we don't borrow from cash envelopes. We can truly accurately track where our money went for the month and for the year. So it's always good to do like an analysis over the course of time. So I'm going to do something a little different here. If you're still with me, I'm going to use this notes section, which I never ever do. So notes, I'm going to put all, well, if I can type, if I can write all extra money to house to get tree removed. Please help me, you guys. If you have any suggestions on how to keep our food budget down this month, or if you know YouTubers who do grocery hauls of super, super cheap budgets, I found this one that was like eating on $10 a week, that kind of thing. Let me know. Leave me some links. Tell me these people, because I need to see them. I got super, super motivated to do like a $10 super, super cheap, but you know, kind of thing for the meals. Let me know these people. Okay, all extra money to house to get tree removed. Focus on long-term wants, not immediate wants. I think that will really help us. Any other goals? What else should I put over there? Focus on long-term wants, not immediate wants. Okay, guys. That's the budget. Let me know if you have any questions. Please, please leave all those suggestions for other YouTubers and other Instagram accounts to follow. And I will see you in the next video. Have a great day, guys. Take care. Bye.